is bakit po natin inunanaw ang mga healthcare workers? Ano po ang ating pong rationale for this season?
Yes, actually, it's not really about vulnerability, no, because it was specifically stated that kahit sa WHO sinabi nila, it's going to be the immunocompromised, the senior citizens, and the healthcare workers. Meron po tayong prioritization framework dito sa ating bansa, yung A1, A2, and A3. These are operational considerations. Unang-una, ang ating mga healthcare workers po, organized na tayo, no? We have our healthcare workers in our facilities. There would just be a few of our healthcare workers who are not related or affiliated with any institution. So mas ma-facilitate po natin at mas ma-mobilize natin agad. The pangalawa, ang ating healthcare workers ang magbabakuna. So kailangan unahin po natin sila so that we can be able to go ahead and vaccinate the others, no? Karagdagang pagbabakuna po kasi itong gagawin natin for boosters. And then of course, the third would be that the healthcare workers will be more protected because they are at higher risk, no, when they are in the hospitals or they face patients. So that's why yung boosters po ay nai-recommenda na mauna sila. But not to say na hindi po natin isusunod agad ang mga seniors at saka mga immunocompromised. Susunod na rin po. So our priority really for this booster and third doses are our healthcare workers, senior citizens, and those with immunocompromised states.
Thank you so much, Yusek. We have another question po for our TAG expert. Maybe Dr. Edsel Salvana can answer this question po. Dr. Edsel, the question po is, kung ang reaksyon ng bakunang pag-uusapan, ano ang pagkakaiba ng posibleng side effects ng homologous sa heterologous booster vaccination?
Yeah, thank you. Ang unang pag-aaral kasi dun sa yung different kinds of mixes, mukhang there is a higher risk of adverse drug reactions. However, hindi naman to severe. So it's really a question of yung harm versus yung benefit. And we know that yung benefit right now, we're still looking at the data. A lot of these are unpublished, not peer-reviewed. Kaya nga, naging parang executive decision to. Kasi if you guys remember, yung ACIP in the US actually did not recommend boosters for healthcare workers, pero in-overrule sila ng CDC. As we get more data, there seems to be more and more data that reflects some clinical advantage, not just antibody. Kasi yung antibody, alam naman natin, pag mag-booster ka, tataas talaga yan. That's natural for anything. But it doesn't necessarily reflect better clinical protection. Now, for instance, yung sa coronavac, we're seeing some data from Chile na yung protection from severe with any of the boosters is more or less the same, whether they used coronavac or Pfizer or Astra for that matter. Pero yung clinical protection seems to be higher, whether it's statistically significant or not. These are not peer-reviewed. For Pfizer, and the best actually is Astra. And that's part of the reason why ngayon dinagdag nga, di ba, the original release, hindi kasama yung Astra. So these are all moving targets. That's the most important thing. And because we recognize that healthcare workers are better to able to understand these nuances than the rest of the population, we are starting with A1 precisely because the data is not as solid as yung original randomized control trial data. And so the considerations here talaga are, number one, safety is first and foremost. And second is yung marginal efficacy ba? Will it na improve? Will it make a difference versus yung possible safety issues with heterologous vaccines? Now, we think that maybe for exposed frontliners, that might be worth it. Pero kung healthcare worker ka na hindi ka naman super exposed, then you might want to go with a safer option, which is homologous. So those are decisions that need to be made on an individual basis. But we feel that it's already time for the healthcare workers to be able to decide if they feel that getting a booster, that's the first thing, whether the booster is needed or not. The data naman shows that protection from severe disease continues ang pinag-uusapan lang natin sa additional booster is increase in clinical protection. In other words, whether magkakasipon ka o hindi. If you think that is useful for you, then go ahead and take the booster. If you would rather wait for more data, then that is completely within your decision point as well.